Welcome everyone to Joshua Okwue Online Maths. Before we start this video, I will encourage you, please, if you have not subscribed to our channel, please, just click the subscription button before you watch this video. Just click the button, okay? And then don't forget to share whatever I'll be doing in this video. If you appreciate it, share it to all your contacts on all your social media platforms. Today we'll be talking about bearing and distance. Yet another simple example to demonstrate that this topic in mathematics is also very simple. The question we'll be demonstrating or we'll be solving today exam says a village R is 10 kilometers from a point P on a bearing of 0.5 degrees from P. Another village A is 6 kilometers from P on a bearing of 162 degrees. Calculate A, distance of R from A. B, the bearing of R from A. Now, first thing as usual, we're going to do what? Represent this information in a diagram. So, an accurate representation of this information will help us to do what? To answer this question and arrive at the correct answer. So follow me now as I'll be doing what representing this information in a diagram. So let's start from the beginning. They say that a village R is 10 kilometers from a point P. Okay? He said on a bearing of 0.5 degrees from P. Remember that word from our onset introduction video, we explained the meaning of and from. So that means that the starting point is what? Is from P. So let's say this is P now. So this is the point P here. Point P. This is point P. On what bearing? 0.25. That means it's going to be on this quadrant. So let's say that this place is what? 25. 0.25 degrees. Okay? He said, a village R is 10 kilometers from a point P on a bearing of 0.25 degrees from P. That means that a village R is somewhere around here. And it's 10 kilometers. 10 kilometers. 10 kilometers. This is it. 10 kilometers. That means that the village is here. R. This is village R. The bearing of R from P is 0.25. That means 25 degrees. What will happen next? You know, say that another village A. Another village A is 6 kilometers from P. Another village again. From this same P. On a bearing of 162 degrees. That means that starting from here now, from the beginning, 90. 162 is going to be in this second quadrant. But this time, what is the distance? Is what, 6 kilometers. Remember, that means the distance is shorter than this, than R. So this village A now is somewhere around here. And is what? Is 6 kilometers. 6 kilometers. You do this whenever you get to any point, you put your four cardinal points. Very important. Good. So this is village A. This is village A here. That is village A. Okay, or we can do this. Let's take it a little bit up now. This is somewhere around here. So this is village A. Okay, now he said calculate distance of RA. So that means we're going to join the distance. This is here. I remember this is shorter, 6 kilometers. So it's going to be from here. It's not straight enough. You try as much as you can to make your line to be straight. Okay. Good. We have this. Good. Perfect. Yeah. Okay. So the question said that calculate the distance of RA. That means this distance here, we are going to calculate it. Okay. So let's calculate that first before we answer the remaining question. So, but first and foremost, let's try to get this point here first. So this is 25 and the bearing of 162 from here to here is 162.
So if I want to get this point here, this angle here, what will I do? I will say 162, that is from here to here, 162 minus 25. 162 minus 25, whatever that remains, here's a value of what? Of this angle here. How following? So using our calculation, and let's quickly do that, okay? So say 162 minus 25, that'll give us what? 137 degrees. So that means that this angle P here is 137 degrees. So what do I do now? I can easily get what? RA. So RA is the side facing what? Angle P. So that is small letter P. Now, what formula will I use now? Will I be using sine rule or cosine rule? Now, remember, I can use cosine rule if one angle is given to me and I'm looking for the opposite side of the angle given, and the two remaining sides are also given, I can use what? The cosine rule. So I'm going to use the cosine rule now to find the distance of what? Of R from what? From A. So from cosine rule now, I can say from cosine rule, I can use P. Let me use P here. Okay, so I can say P square is equals to any of them. I can say R A square plus R square minus 2AR cos P. That is capital letter P. That is angle P. Now, what is A? A is the side facing angle A. And what is small letter R? R is the side facing what? R. So this equals to what? A is what? 10 square plus R is what? 6 square minus 2 times 10 times 6 times cos 1, 3, 7. Okay, so what do I do from here now? I can use my calculator now. 10 squared means 10 times 10, that is 100. Plus 6 squared means 6 times 10, that is 36. Minus 2 times 10 is 20. 20 times 6 is 120. Okay? Now look at this cos 137. If you should press cos 137 in your calculator, you will see you are going to get minus. So that minus times this minus, this will change to what? To plus. Okay? So now I'm going to do what? I'm going to multiply all this together. I will say 120 now. Times cos 137. Okay, so that will give us what? 87.7624. So what am I going to do? I'm going to add everything together now. So I'm going to add everything. I'll say this 136 plus 87.7624. And so this is what? 223.7624. So that is what? P squared. So P is equal to, you take the square root of 223.7624. So what is square root of that? Use your calculator again. 223.7624. So this is what? 14.95. Or you can say P is approximately 15 kilometers. So the distance of R from A, the distance of R from A is what? Is 15, approximately what? 15 kilometers. Now I calculate the bearing of R from A. Aha! The bearing of R from A. That means this angle here. The bearing of R from A, starting from this point. So that means we are looking at this angle here. What is the value of this angle? This angle, that is what you are looking for. So the value of R from A is the value of this angle here. This little place you are seeing here. So I can call it theta. Okay, this angle here, what is the value of this theta? That is it. So we're going to calculate the bearing of R from A now. So for me to get the bearing of R from A, I need to get what? This angle A. So after getting angle A, I will do something to it to get. Remember, this is just what I need. This is just what I need. Okay, so what I will do is that after calculating this angle, I will subtract this from the total angle to give me the bearing of what? Of R from A. So that's what I'm going to do. How will I get that? Remember, from here to here is 160. That means that this angle we are seeing here is what? Is 18 degrees. So if this is 18 degrees, that means that the whole of this angle here, that is alternate, is also what? 18 degrees. Okay, so I'm going to get the value of A now. So after getting the value of A, I'll subtract 18 from it to give me this bearing of what? Of R from A. So what will I do? Using what? This time I'm going to use what? Using sine rule now. So I'm looking for what I'll say A over sine A is equals to, now I've calculated this, like I use P. I can say P over what? Sine P. So what is A? A is the side facing angle. A, that is what? 10 over sine. I don't know it. I'm looking for that. P is what? I've calculated P approximately what? 15. 15 over what? Sine P. So what will you do from there? We'll cross multiply. So if I cross multiply, we'll be having, when I cross my plan, make A the subject of the formula, this will be what? 10 times sine. Oh, we have sine P. Sine P is what? 137. So let's quickly substitute that. Times sine 137 over 15. So use your calculator now. So we use your calculator to do that. Okay? So you say 10 times sine 137. So that gives us what? So say sine A now is equals to 6.81998 divided by 15. So divide this now by 15. So sine A is equals to 0.4547. So A is equals to what? Sine inverse of 0.4547. So how do we press sine inverse? You say second function sine 0.4547. And that gives us what? Angle A is equals to what? 27.05. Okay? So angle A, the whole of this angle is what? 27.05. Now I will now want to get this answer. Therefore, the bearing of R from A is equals to what now? Is equals to what? I'm not going to do what, since I know this angle here to be what? 18. And I'm looking for this. And the whole of this angle here is what? 27.05. And this alone is already what? 18 degrees. That is alternate to this angle. So, and this is what I'm looking for, this remaining one. To get this remaining one, what will I do? I will say 27.05 minus 18. 27.05 minus what? 18. So when you subtract 18 from this, minus 18. So our answer will be what? 9.04. So R is approximately, sorry, so that is approximately what? 9 degrees. So the bearing of R from A is approximately 9 degrees. It's approximately what? 9 degrees. And that is the answer. So it's not difficult at all. So all we need to do is that we'll look at the nature of the question. The nature of the question will determine the approach that we're going to do what? Apply to do what? To answer the question. So this is it. It's not difficult. To understand this better, I encourage you to watch this video over and over again. Once you're able to do that, I assure you, you will find out that to do this is very simple, because it's just straightforward. Just obey the rule. When you're asked to add, you add, subtract. When you're taking the square, you take the square, you see the answer, will just do what? Appear. Once again, thank you so much for always visiting my channel. I appreciate you so much. Please share these videos on all your social media platforms. By doing so, you'll be helping us, you'll be promoting us, because that is exactly what we need from you. Once again, thank you so much. Bye-bye for now.